welcome to Parental Fun. And we are Jeff, and we're going to check this cool place out and teach you how to pick up painting as a hobby.
Hi, I'm Ellie, and I'm a Paint for Fun instructor. And today we're going to run you through a couple of things at the fabulous Art Shed. So we know you've loved our classes, and we know we've inspired you to keep painting. So I'm just going to take you through a couple of things that you may not have picked up already, but something that I can help you develop your painting with a bit further as well. So at the Art Shed in Moorabin, where there is everything you could imagine that you would need to be creative and get painting. So today, as one of our tutorials, we're going to focus on acrylic paint, which is our main style of painting at Paint for Fun. So the absolute basics that you will need to start with is a canvas or something to paint on. You can get this in the style of a patch, you can get it in a panel, or on a canvas, up to you what you want to paint with. If you just want to start with something small to get going, fair enough. That's what you need to start in that department. The next thing you would need is some brushes. Brushes you can get singly, and you can go for rounds, you can go for flats, angles, whatever you like. You can get a little starter kit, which is really good, and have all different sizes for doing different things, thick lines, thin lines. And then this sort of style comes in a little case where you can have that all together. And that gives you a variety as well for whatever you're painting for that day. So far we've got the canvas, we've got the brushes. How about something to put the paint on? You can have a start with a little basic palette like that, or you can go one with sections. And these have sections for mixing colors in. So, moving on to the paints, you can start with, this is a basic colour kit to mix your own colours, and we're going to show you that as we go along as well, how to mix colours, but I think the easiest way is just to buy a pack of 12 different colours. Otherwise, you can go and a larger set, and this is 18. And then the more colours that you have, the less mixing you need to do. So that makes it easier for you as well. So they're really the basics that you need. If you don't want to go and pick out all individually, you can also get kits. And the kits range from a few things to a lot. This one actually even includes an easel, which is fun to paint with your piece upright. So that's a little bit about what you would need to paint with acrylics. So let's get started, get out and get your pieces, and you'll find everything here at the Art Shed. But if you're not sure still, come and have a few lessons with us and that'll get you going. Look forward to seeing you. Hi again, I'm Ellie and welcome back. This time I'm gonna take you through my personal favorite watercolors. I love watercolors. It's only something very new to me, but as soon as I picked up that brush and put it to paper, I knew this was the medium for me. So starting off with watercolor paper, for what you paint on, you can get it in all different sorts, but my one tip to you is always make sure that you go 300 GSM weight cotton paper, because with watercolor, you will find that it does ruffle a little. So when the paper is wet, it will expand and leaves a little wave. But what you can do is tape it down with some masking tape, but ensure that you buy 300 GSM paper. And here I am holding 180. Okay, so yeah, the most important thing, 100% cotton, 300 GSM. You can get paper in all different types. You can get it in rough, you can get it cold pressed, you can get it hot pressed, and it just gives you a different look every time you paint on it, depending on which paper you get. Okay, so moving on from the paper, you can actually get it in a canvas as well. I haven't actually painted on the canvas, but I've heard it's very similar. But if you already had a canvas out there that isn't for watercolor, you can paint a medium over it. So that's another thing you can do as well. So once you've got your canvas, you can buy it in a book, you can buy it loose, you can buy it huge, you can buy it tiny, all different sizes. You can also buy it in a block. And the block is a great way to start out. So what the block is that it's all glued down all around the sides except for one little spot. So it's all glued down. One little spot you can get your palette knife in and then just take it off at the end. And that keeps it flat. But if you didn't have the block, you could use your masking tape to tape it all the way around, and that keeps it flat for the whole duration of your painting. Once you take the masking tape off, you'll have less of a wave. So that's the one hard thing with watercolor. With the brushes, I use one brush, but you can get all different kinds of brushes. The difference between the watercolor brushes to acrylic brushes is they're a lot softer and they hold the water and just disperse it differently to an acrylic brush. You can use an acrylic brush, and I personally use acrylic brushes for watercolor painting because I like the accuracy of it more. With watercolor paper, you've got to leave a lot of it to the paper and the brush and the color, because you don't always have full control, and that's what I love. It'll do a lot for you by just putting the paint onto the paper, which can be exciting because you never know exactly where it's going to go. But the thing with watercolor is when you're painting watercolor onto the paper, it's wherever you put the water that it will flow. If you haven't tried watercolor before, it's a really fun medium to try. It's a little bit harder, I find, than acrylic, but that's where Paint for Fun comes in, because you can come and paint with us. And we'll give you the first couple of basics to start you, and then you can go from there. So we've covered the canvas, we've covered the brushes, now the paint, the most amazing colors. It tends to be the more you pay for the paint, the more intense the pigment is. You can get the paint in two different ways. You can get it in like a, what would you say?
A tube.
I couldn't even think, I went blank. So yeah, like a liquid. So we've got it in a liquid, or you've got it in a cake. So a cake is like a hard piece of paint, and it's activated by water. And there is a lot of intensity of ink in these colors as well. It's personal preference. If you're on the go and traveling, this little kit you can mix colors with and is great. But if you want to have the convenience of having so many different colors that you don't have to mix, the tubes are also really good for that. You'll find as you go along what you prefer to use with it. And then you can use all different things. And we're going to show you in some of the tutorials coming up. You can add some salt, or you can add some alcohol and have a whole different look. You could even use some iridescent paints, some metallics. There's so many different things you can use. But that really is the basics of watercolor painting. The thing that I love is it's less mess. It's so easy to wash your brush. And you can leave your palette with all the colors on there, come back a few weeks later, add some water and reactivate and continue on with your painting, which is really fun. So yeah, I really encourage you to start and have a class with us on watercolor painting. You will love it. It's a lot of fun. So I'll see you in class.
Hey everyone, I'm Ruby, and now we're in the sketching place. So I know sketching is not as popular. People get a little bit intimidated when they look at complicated shape and how I'm going to do. But I encourage you to do try to do some sketching, especially when you're out and about. That will teach you a lot about perspective, about scale, about objects and representation. And part of Paint for Fun called Dia, the Art of Creative Thinking. And we're using art as a tool to generate creative thinking, to look at things differently and actually focus and see the reality as it is. So sketching really helps. You can go in the city, for example, which I like, and just go and sketch some buildings, for example, or look at your hand and kind of try to sketch your hand. But what do you need to start? So, and the first thing is a drawing sketchbook. don't need to go fancy. It can be even A4 papers. This one is obviously, this is 220 GSM. So it's thicker. And you can have just a sketching book that you take everywhere with a little pencil case. So what you will put on your pencil case? We have a sketching set. So a sketching set has charcoals in it, have four of pencils. So you have HB, 2B, 4B, and 6B. The more B you have, the softer it is. And then you can create many scales of gray using all those pencils. You have, this is a smudging tool, really, really fun that you can work with a charcoal, your eraser, and also a sharpener. So this is a really good sketching set. So just to get you started on that. You can get them separately, so you can actually get the charcoal separately. It's really messy, but it's really fun as well. And then you have your color. So, unlike paint, like I said, with sketching you use usually gray, but on top of it you can work with either oil pastel. If you have kids, this is awesome. It's not messy, you can do it together. I mean, and you probably have it at home. I'm using it. And then we have the skin color pencil, or just color pencil. So you have all these beautiful colors that can work in layers. Some of them are watercolors, so you can use brushes and water. So like I said, this is something you can carry with you when you go camping or when you go in nature and do something that is not messy and doesn't require a lot of setup. We like to use a mannequin, so you can do like fun poses and every time try a different areas, learn about the body, you know, how it moves, how it looks. You don't need to be an artist in order to sketch. It's actually a really fun activity and you can learn so much about everything around you by just observing line and shape and try to do it. What's the worst that can happen? You can just erase it, right? So yeah, hope to see some of your sketching things. I'm gonna teach you about perspective and we're gonna do some nature sketching and how to find, you're in a park, how to find what to paint. So these are two tutorials that I'll teach you, and then with these materials you can start and sketch fun.